This video is for you if you're trying to learn GrandMA3. In this video, we're going to go through 7 really cool things about the GrandMA3, 7 really cool, like, hidden gems, things you wouldn't normally know, things you wouldn't normally look at, things that wouldn't normally be in any basic tutorial. So this is 7 cool steps and 7 cool tips of the GrandMA3 console that is going to make you a much better GrandMA3 programmer. Let's get into it. The first feature we're going to talk about today is Fix. And what is Fix? Let me just show you what it can do for you. I'm here on a playback page, and I'm here on screen number 2. If you close this one down and you go into your screens here and you say screen 2, I rearranged it so I have all my playbacks collected on one screen. Down here you can change the page from page 1 to page 2. Say for instance, this is the page you use for song number 1. You click this one and you are listening to song number 2. But you want to reuse stuff in here. You want to reuse your color cues, your spots, your odd even stuff down here. And you don't want to build it again and you don't want to assign it again. So how can we fix this? And we can fix that with the fix keyword. So if you type fix in the command line, let's just say fix, and then you can touch one of the faders up here. You can see it turns a small yellow or orange style up here. And if we click to the next page, the fixed fader stays up on the page so you don't have to rebuild it. So let me just show you again. You type fix or you press the fix keyword and you simply do that to all the spots you want to, all the faders you want to keep on the next page. So right now we have song number 1 on page number 1. If I change page, we are in song number 2. And everything else stayed on the faders. That's the fix keyword. I use it all the time. The next thing I'm going to show you is minus. You've tried saying fixture this, plus fixture this, plus fixture this, and then store it into a group. You can actually do the same thing with minus. So let's say we have all our mega points here. We have selected all of them. Let's just clear that again and say, okay, we want to make an odd group and an even group. So we can say fixture 1, 3, 5... 8, 10, 12, that makes a fine symmetrical group. We can simply say store and put that into a new group right here. Let's clear that again. To make the even group, we could select them all again like we did before, and that's no problem if you have 12 moving lights as we have right here. But if you have maybe 100 or maybe 50 or whatever, then it can be a little bit difficult. So what you can do is you can say all my mega points, go into the command section and say minus the group we just made, and now you selected the opposite or the even group. If you store that into another group, you have your odd group here and your even group here. It's an invaluable tool and you're going to use it all the time. You'll find yourself using it all the time, the minus keyword or the minus button. The next thing we're going to talk about is SelFix or select fixture. It's a keyword and you can find it on the fader wing or on the button section of your GrandMA3 disc. SelFix is quite a cool little thing. So let's just clear out here and say, okay, you're sitting as a programmer and your designer is pointing at a fader. For instance, this master fader here, odd fader. And say, okay, I want you to select whatever's in this fader and I want you to take the intensity down, for instance, or whatever it could be. And maybe you don't label everything correctly. So you forgot if the odd fader is this one or you forgot if it's this one. So how do you find out? Well, it's quite simple. You simply type SelFix or you press the SelFix button and then you simply touch the fader and it selects whatever is in this sequence. So it can be everything if you're doing a massive show and then it's not very useful. But if you only have like an odd fader, an even fader or whatever, to basically select everything that's in here, SelFix, and then push the fader and you have everything selected as you can see here. If we clear it out and we say SelFix to the other one, it select of course what's in that one. So that's the SelFix button. You'll find yourself using that one as well all the time. The next thing we're going to look at in this quick overview of some different functions is the off-off command. The off-off command can help you if you want to make sure that everything is turned off on your console. As you can see right here, we have a song running. You can see the status right here. It's active. Some color cues are active. An odd and even wash is active. And basically, you don't know if there's something something else active on your console. Maybe there's a timecode running. Maybe there's something running right now. You want to make sure that everything is turned off. What you do is you go into your command section here and you double tap the off button like this. Then you can see there's a timecode running. And if you go up here, you can see there's a few sequences running. And there's a macro window here, and you can see there's no macros running right now. So if we say we want to turn everything off, or maybe just one thing at a time, in our off window right here, you can simply click and they disappear. That means they're off. If you want to make absolutely sure, you can turn off all sequences down here or everything down here. If you push this one, you can see everything is now turned off. Everything is gone down here and the timecode stopped running as well. So that's the off command. One of the things, again, you're going to use frequently, quite frequently, because sometimes you just want to make sure that everything is turned off before you leave the desk or whatever. So that's the off command. In a minute, we're going to continue with some more features of the GrandMA3. If you get anything out of this small video tutorial right now, please be sure to hit the like button. Hitting the like button on any YouTuber's videos will help the video spread to more people on YouTube. So it's going to help us out a lot. It's a free way to support any YouTube channel. And while you're down there in that section, if you want to make sure that you don't miss any future videos from this channel, you are more than welcome to subscribe to the channel as well, and make sure to click the little bell icon down in the corner so you get a notification every time we upload a new video. So let's continue with some more features of the GrandMA3. The next feature we're going to look at is the park option. The park option is also something I use quite frequently, actually. Sometimes when I do front light, sometimes when I do when I work in a venue and they ask me to do something specific. That could be, for instance, if we if they say, okay, we have a bar area over here, please make sure you never turn the light off in that area. And when you are programming your console, sometimes it's quite difficult not to turn something off at some point when you're preparing your show. So what you can do is we go into just one of the mega points here, and this could be anything. We just turn it on and we double tap the pause button on the in the command section. Let me just show you right here. You go in here into your command section and you locate the pause button, and it's right down here, and you tap it once and twice, and then you can see this park keyword down here. You can also just write it out in your command line. Now the park is active. What do we want to park? We have selected mega point number one, and we've just turned the intensity at full. So we can simply say, I want to park dimmer. As you can see up here right now, there's a blue indicator here indicating that something is parked. So if we clear out here, you can see the blue indicator stays here. The dimmer stays on, and the fixture is now parked. That means that you can grab the fixture, but you can't turn it off anymore. And even if you go into the off command I showed you before and you say everything off, it's still going to be on because it's parked. So that's another really cool feature. And you can do more with it. You can unpark it. Let's just try to unpark it. You do that with tapping your Go Plus button twice. Let me just show you in the command section here. You have the Go Plus button here. First time it's Go Plus. Next time it says unpark. And then you simply select mega point number one and it unparks everything. Let me show you another thing you can do. If you take mega point number one again, you turn it on. You take your position here and you say, okay, I'm doing my front light now. Usually I just use conventional light for this, but today I have moving lights and I want to make sure that they stay in their position. So we turned it on and we put it into the lead singer. Let's just say we did. And then we say park, position, and we clear. Once again, you can see something is parked up here because it's blue. And if we take mega point number one again, and we let's just make sure we clear everything. We take mega point one again and we turn it on. And as you can see, it stayed in that position. And if I grab my pan and tilt now, you can see nothing is happening because the pan and tilt values are parked. You can park everything, all parameters. You can park an entire fixture, every parameter if you want to. Let's just try to do that. I selected mega point number one. I say please, please, because that selects, as you can see, everything up here. And we simply once again say park and then fixture mega point number one. And now if we clear out, Everything, as you can see, is parked and it's indicated by the blue color up here. Once again, if we want to unpark it, we can simply say go plus twice and then touch mega point number one and it removes everything. What you also can do is say unpark and then say gobo, for instance, then it's only going to unpark the gobo parameter. Park, very useful feature. The next feature I'm going to show you is the snap go and snap minus shortcut of feature. Sometimes if you are programming a show like we have this one, we have a lot of times put in here. And if you're doing like a theater show, sometimes these timings can be very, very, very long. And if you want to go from this cue, it's a 2 second fade. Then we go into the next cue, it's a 10 second fade. And when you're programming and this designer left and you want to make some changes, waiting for these times is sometimes really, really annoying. So what can you do? Well, let's just go all the way through and start over. If you go into the command section, and I'm not sure you can do this on the UnPC version, maybe you can, but just remember that it's a possibility. You have these buttons down here. And if you use the hard keys on a real console, I'm going to try to show you something really cool here. If you hold down the right one, if you hold it down, as you can see up here now, when I push my plus button, it just snaps from one cue to the next. And if I hold down the left one, it goes backwards, but without any timing. So when you want to go through a lot of programming, using this button, holding it down, tapping through everything makes programming going from queue to queue, if you just want to do some changes, a lot easier. So that's the snap plus and the snap minus. So basically you need this if you are programming and if you don't want to wait for all the timings, this is an invaluable tool and it's really easy to use. So push the right one down to go forward, put the left one down to go backwards, and then the timings are gone while you're holding it down. That's another cool feature of the GrandMA3. We're going to continue with some more features of the GrandMA3 in a minute, but before that, I just want to tell you that if you are interested in GrandMA3 equipment, you can check some of the links below in the description where you can go in and look at some real GrandMA3 hardware. You can see some prices and you can see all the different features and read a little bit more about each different piece of hardware. So that's down in the description. And remember, they are affiliate links, so if you decide to purchase something, it's a good way to support this channel so we can continue making videos. And please leave a comment down below if you have any questions or have anything you want to say. If you want to tell me where you're coming from, which country you live in, that's always valuable to me to see that we actually have viewers basically from all over the world on this small new channel. So that's just wonderful to see. Leave a comment down below if you have any questions. Let's continue with some more features of the GrandMA3. The next thing I'm going to show you is Group Master. And what is a Group Master? A Group Master is what it says, a master for a group of fixtures. We can basically control the intensity of a Group Master. And when do you need a Group Master? Well, I use it when I do some touring and I clone my fixtures from one fixture type to the other. And the show I do is quite small, so sometimes you'll get like mega points indoors or some beamy kind of fixture indoors, and they can be really, really powerful, especially when you're lighting the audience. So I like to assign all my festival fixtures to a group master so I can control the intensity if they get too bright. And what you do is you basically say assign, you take, for instance, all our mega points, you select them, and you simply select a master down here in the master section. Now this is a group master and I can take this down and then that will control the intensity of all the fixtures that are in this group. So if I update this group to contain more fixtures, it will still work down here as long as you updated it right up here. So basically this will take the intensity up and down for the selected group. Just make sure you remember that you have a group master, because if you are hiding a group master on a different page and you turned it all the way down, your lights is not going to work. So you can see this indicator up here that all your fixtures or your fixtures are in a group master because it's 0% up here. You can even go into the settings in here and you can see which blending mode is used in here. So if you are in doubt and if there's no light coming out of your fixture, make sure that you check the GroupMaster up here. So that is GroupMaster, very, very useful tool on the GrandMA3. Be sure to like the video and maybe even subscribe to the channel if you find this video useful. And if you want to learn more about GrandMA3, be sure to check out this video you can see on your screen right now, where we go through another cool feature of the GrandMA3. This was more like a special episode, and if you are keen for more, please come back to the channel some other time. And until then, happy GrandMA3 programming.